Assalamu alaikum, how are you, my dear students? Today we will be discussing a very important session, which is how to understand and memorize the multiplication table easily. It is a super easy way to understand the multiplication table. First of all, let me think about the multiplication table about as 10 parts from 1 to 10. The multiplication table of 1 is very easy, and all the students know that if you multiply a number by 1, the answer will be the same number. If you multiply 5 by 1, the answer is 1, 5. If you multiply 9 by 1, the answer is 9. So in this case, we can cross the 1. Because it's already finished. This easy one. Now let's go to the multiplication table of 2. It is also a very easy multiplication table, because if you multiply any number by 2, is the same as adding this number to itself. If you multiply 6 by 2, it means 6 multiply plus 6 equals 12. If you multiply 5 by 2, it means 5 plus 5 equals 10. If you multiply 7 by 2, equals 7 plus 7 equals 14. So the multiplication table also very easy, and we can cross it. We already highlighted the multiplication of 1, it is finished. Now, 3 and 4 are the most difficult multiplication tables. If you understand them and memorize them, you will find it's easy for you to memorize all the multiplication tables. So I start by 3. How I teach my students the multiplication table of 3? I teach them to count by 3. How? 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, so on. Then I let them repeat, but fast. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, like this. 3, 6, 9, 12, like this. Then I tell them to repeat it as fast as they can. Then by this way, they memorize the multiplication table of 3. If I ask them then, 3 multiply 6, they directly remember it's what? 18. So if you, they know now, 1 times 3, 3, 2 times 3, 6, 4 times 3, 12. So if you ask them now, not in an ordered way, in mixed way, they remember it because they repeated too much time in the same way. So by this, we finish the multiplication table of 3. Now, as I told you, the multiplication for, table of 4 is the same as multiplication table of 3, which consider is difficult. So I teach them the same way. Count by 4. 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24. Then they repeat. 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28, so on. They keep repeating, counting by 4, then I teach them this, the multiplication table of 4. So four, they remember 4 times 5 equals 20, 4 times 4 equals 16. After they get it, they can answer the multiplication table of 4, even if you not ask them in the same order. If you ask them 4 times 8, they remember directly because they counted by 4, it is 32. So by this way, they master the multiplication table of 4. So I cross it. Now, the multiplication table of 5, all the students like it because it's easy to remember. It's end by 5 or what? Or 0, 5, 10, 15, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. It ends with 5 or 10. So it is very easy to remember. So we cross the multiplication table of 5. Now, I skip 6 and 7 and 8, I go to 9 and 10. What about 10? It's very easy. 0 is the hero. 0 is the hero. If you multiply a number by 10, you just add 0 to the number, to that number. 5 times 10 equals the same number 5, but you add it, add 0 to it. It becomes 50. We say, to remember this, 0 is the hero. 0 is the hero. By remembering this, you know, 6 times 10 equals 60. 7 times 10 equals 70. You just add 0 to the number that you multiply by 10. So multiplication table of 10 is very easy. Now we come to multiplication table of 9. A lot of teachers and students have many ways to memorize the multiplication table of 9. First of all, we should know the answer or the product of multiplication table, all the products of multiplication table of 9, the sum of these two digits is 9. But let me show you the way. Here, if you have 9 multiply 4 equals. So I already know that the answer is 36. If you add 3 plus 6 equals 9, always the sum of the digits of the product is 9. So how I get it? I multiply 9 by 4. I decrease the number that I multiply by 9 by 1. So 4 minus 1 equals what? 3. Then I complete 3 plus what equals 9? 3 plus 6. Another example. You like it? 9 multiply 7. I don't know. But you can say 7 minus 1 equals 6. And I need 3 to become 9. So 63. Another example. 9 multiply 8. 8 minus 1 equals 7. 7 needs 2 to become 9. So I add 2. By this way, we finish the multiplication table of 9. Now, what about 6 and 7 and 8? I come here, this already done, because I already study the multiplication table of 1. So 6 times 1, 6, 7 times, خلاص, I study it in multiplication table of 1. Here, these numbers, the multiplication table of them with 2 already done in the multiplication table of 2. Here, I already know that 6 times 3, 18, 7 times 3, 21, 8 times 3 equals 24 because I have studied them in the multiplication table of 3. The same as for multiplication table of 4, the same as for multiplication table of 5. Now, the same as multiplication table of 10. Already I know 7 times 10 is 70. 0 is the hero. Already I know the multiplication table of 9, so I know. Already. 6 multiply 9, 6 minus 1, 5. 5 needs 4 to become 9. So now I just have these 9 squares to memorize. How I memorize them? Here, if you can see, it's easy to remember squares. 6 times 6, 7 times 7, 8 times 8. 6 times 6, 7 times 7, 8 times 8. It is very easy to remember them. So, this already done. Okay. Because it's easy to remember the squares. It's easy to remember the squares. Now I just need to memorize 3 numbers, 3 multiplication problems. 7 multiply 6 equals 42. 6 multiply 7 equals 42. 6 multiply 8, 48. 8 multiply 6, 48. 8 multiply 7, 56. 8 is 7 multiply 8, 56. So I just need to remember these three multiplication problems. By this way, we understand and we memorized the multiplication table in an easy way. Let me summarize what I said in 2 minutes or less than 2 minutes. Multiplication table of 1 and 10 is very easy. 1 keeps the number as it is. 10 just we add 0. Multiplication table of 2, we just add the number to itself. Multiplication table of 4 and 3, you just use the way of counting by 3 or counting by 4. The multiplication table of 5, it ends with 5 or 0. So it's easy to remember. Now the multiplication table of 9, as I said, if I say 9 multiply 7, I deduct 1 from 7, it becomes 6. This is the tens. I want the ones I need to complete 6 to 9, so I add 3 because the sum of the digits is 9. Now I'm remaining with 6, 7, 8, but 6 times 1, and these numbers with 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 5, we already memorized them. So I have just 9 squares. I deleted 3 of them because these are squares and students tend to memorize squares. 6 times 6, 36. This is the first thing I have memorized in multiplication table when I was a child. 7 times 7, 49. 8 times 8, 64. Now just you have 3 numbers to remember. 7 times 6, 42 and vice versa. 8 times 7, 8 times 6, 48, and 7 times 8 is 56. I hope this super easy way with Mr. Moab JB find you in a good way and you find it easy to memorize the multiplication table and understand how it works. Thank you very much.